Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to input images in Gemini AI API. So let's get started. First thing, just google Google AI Studio and click on the first link, and here make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. And here they are having this link for documentation. Click it and will be taken to the official Gemini AI API documentation. Here, if you just scroll down, we are having text generation under core capabilities. Select this, and here just scroll down, and we'll be having this multimodal input. And here they are having a sample code how to input image along with the text prompt. So I'll be showing in Python. So let me just copy this code. And here I'm having a new Python file over here. Let me just paste it. So now we need to do two things. First is to install the necessary Python package, and after that we need to add the Gemini AI API key. So let's do both. So to get the latest package name and installation guide, you are having this API reference, right? Just open it in a new tab, and here we'll be having the latest scripts. For example, if I go to Python, here is the latest pip command that I need to run. So I'll just copy this and go here to terminal and just run this. We need to have this API key equals inside our client. So just go here again, paste it, and within double quotes we need to have our API key. So to get the API key, just go to Google AI Studio. Here we are having get API key. Select it, click on create API key. Select the project, create API key, copy it. Don't share this to anyone. If you want, you can delete the key also over here. After this, either you can have it in an environment variable or access it, or you can simply directly access this. So I'll just paste it, the API key. And now we are done. Next thing is we need to have an image. So I will just put my image in the same folder. If you do that, you just have to specify the image name, else you need to specify the whole path. So this is the image that I'm having, an image of a cat. So I'll just go here and change the path to just the file name. So you need to have cat.png with the extension, don't forget that. And rest the code is pretty straightforward. We are having the API key here, and we are passing the model name, which is Gemini 2.5 flash. And apart from that, inside contents we are passing a list. The first element in the list is an image, which is our image, and next is the prompt that we are going to give. So I'll just have tell me about this image. Okay, and that's pretty much it. Saving it, and let me just run it. Python space new dot py and hit enter, and we have got the response. It says a plump ginger cat in a background setting, and damn, just look at the description, how beautifully it has explained. So it's working perfectly fine, and it doesn't stop here. We are also having multiple ways how we can input an image. So let me just go to the text generation and the same multimodal input. Here we are having below that, see our image understanding guide. Just open this. So this will show us all the possible ways how we can input image in Gemini AI API. So first, passing inline image data. So we provide the base64 encoded version of the image, and we directly send this. A similar way that we did here also, we're just directly passing it. If you want to try it out, you can try it out. And next one is fetching the image from a URL. So here it says, right, you can fetch the image from a URL, convert it to bytes, and then pass it to generate content. So if we can try this out. So let me just copy this code and just replace this. And this is the code. Basically, we are passing the URL of the image that is hosted in the web. After that, we are converting it to bytes, and then the similar flow. We are giving the prompt as well as the image that is in bytes, and we are also passing the MIME type over here. And make sure that you're getting this MIME type from the image that is hosted. Like, I guess they are hard-coded it over here. So now let me just change the image path. Let me give my own URL. This is basically a vector image of the earth. So don't forget to add the API key in the client. So now let's run this and see if it can find the earth image. Works perfectly. If you want, you can try this URL method also. and we are done with this URL method. Next, if you scroll down, we can upload images using the file API. The great difference is for large files or to able to use the same image file repeatedly, we can use this files API. So they're also having a separate guide for this. If we open it, by using this files API, we can upload different types of file. As you can see, files, text prompt, system instructions, etc. Here they have showed a example of uploading a MP3. So MP3, PDF, you can literally upload different types of files with this files API. You can just try it out. And apart from that, let me just scroll down. Next, we are having prompting with multiple images. So you can just try it out in case if you want to like pass multiple images. Here they have got the image one, image two path, and they are just passing it. You can just try this out. And apart from that, in image, we are having this object detection. So basically the prompt is detect all the prominent items in the image. So they're also giving the coordinates of that image, and yep, you can also like try this out. It basically gives the bounding boxes and stuff from the response. They're actually deconstructing it. So you can also try this out. And apart from that, they're having the segmentation quite similar to this, along with the bounding boxes and specifying what exactly is in that image. You can even like try this out. So that's totally up to you what you're going to do with this image input. And that's the video, guys. I hope you have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in Gemini AI, OpenAI API, and other programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.